was saying it was exhausting.
It is. It is. It, you know, we got off stage last night, and I was telling to Jordan, or telling Jordan, it's like, man, I'm like shot every time we walk off stage, and it's not because it's such an overwhelmingly physical show, but he was like, you know what it is? It's a really emotionally draining show, and there's a lot that has to go right. There's a lot of cues. It's all synced up to this crazy video that we did. And so you're kind of like in battle mode, you know, for 2.5 hours, whatever it is. And so when you walk off, you know, because you're at that heightened emotional state, you walk off and you kind of feel this drain almost. You know, but it's different than, let's say, you know, playing a set of music that's all, you know, crazy songs that are hard to play and fast and everything. That's a different kind of...
different mindset.
Yeah, when you walk up stage, you might be physically a little bit more drained, but this is like an emotional drain.
You're kind of playing this concept album from beginning to completion.
Yeah.
And it's, I guess it's not like anything else that, you know, I can't think of a band that's doing that kind of thing as a concept, you know, from start to finish, like without any other songs in between or, you know, that kind of thing.
Yeah, well, you know, I kind of thought back to The Wall when Pink Floyd toured for that, and that's how they approached that tour. You know, they presented The Wall live, and you went to see that show. There weren't encores or anything. I thought that was really cool. And when you see it, you'll see that it makes sense because, you know, the show is a very sort of powerful ending that's very conclusive to the story, and it would be just really weird to all of a sudden play Pull Me Under or something. Yeah, it just wouldn't feel right, you know.